folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play RimWorld. We're at Alpha 13, Cougar's Hope, though lately it's been more of a, a Grizzly's Hope. Just kind of looking around here, we've got two sets of two Grizzlies, and none of them are ready to eat this time, and they're sure making a bloody mess of their areas. And then it was brought up to me in several of the comments that it's actually more like Turtle's Hope. We've had a hatching. Boy, do we have turtles now. So, need to think about a place for them and how to use them. You know, the idea of the, the killer turtle death squad or brute squad. Something I kind of want to play with just out of curiosity's sake. Anyway, I went through, edited this a little bit more, got rid of the extra walls that I had placed in here. Even more so, and compacted things. So I think that's pretty much the final plan. Vapa had buried himself in the wall over here, so I dug him out just before we started. I see Remy's taken down another wild boar and got scratched a few times. Right eye is scratched. That's not good. Do we still have a Selma? I haven't actually noticed Selma much lately. We still do, right over there. Okay. We just don't have a... what was the name of our other husky? And a Norman, and can't think of the other. We lost one husky. But what else is happening around the map here? Brand is trying once more to recruit Hippo. Natalia's getting a good meal. Rabbit is tending to Michael. That's right, Michael, who is recuperating from the flu. He's 79% done. He's still at minor. Klaus also was here. He was also hit by the flu, right? Yep. And he is 78% and minor. And then we had a couple of plague victims. I want to think it was Nettie. Right? Plague. She's already developed immunity. And the other was Manuel. There he is. And same thing. He's already developed immunity. So they're all fine. This late in the game, it's kind of hard to kill them in the sense that we've got good quality hospital beds, we've got doctors that have got some significant skills now, and there's a lot more flexibility. Early in the game, you can be wiped out by these pretty quickly, but we're doing pretty good right now. This base has really grown. Of course, I've been at this series for almost a year. Well, taking the summer off sure messed up my time schedules. But, yeah, look at the number of rooms in this base now. When we do get into the next series of RimWorld, who knows what alpha that'll be, Alpha 20, I want to get back to a mountain map. I want to dig into the mountain and do it the way I used to do it. Lots of resources available. We're going to be scraping bottom soon on our steel and plasteel and what have you. Really, it's whatever's left in this one. And that little guy over there, there's not much more to mine. Over here is some more. We're going to need to buy all of the steel that we can find from here on out. Whatever traders show up. Anyway, have I covered everything? Let me look at my notes. I did do a few things that I knew if I didn't do it beforehand, I would forget again. Because once I turn the game on, the game has a way of dictating what I do rather than... I don't control the game. The game controls me. I did just plant Double Strand in here. It was brought up that since I researched it, may as well make use of it. And we could definitely use a lot more than that. Let's see here. They haven't really gone in to plant this one yet. We could get one season out of that Devil Strand. Let's go this way. It has a long growth time. What am I looking at here? Growing time 22 days. So that's a season and a half. Versus something like rice. Hay grass. Okay, hay grass is 5 days. This was rice. Cotton, what are you? 2.7 days. Cotton grows fast. So cotton you can have in a smaller field, and it'll just keep producing over and over and over again. Your main limit is how quickly your people can get in there and actually replant and sow and reap. Potatoes, grow time 3 days. So, yeah, Devil Strand. I mean, I wish I could use this thing just for Devil Strand. But the herbal medicine is also quite important. We ran out over the winter, not thinking that that was even possible. Of course, RimWorld has a way of tossing diseases at you now to wipe out your medical supplies. Still got several of them triggered to walk over here and dump stone down so that Eric and Rokes can just walk from space to face space and just build. So Catherine's going to bring another big pile of it over. I was going to sit there and watch her do that. I'm not anymore. A group of pirates from the Murderers of Hostility have arrived in drop pods nearby. There are times when they arrive right on top of you. They'll blast right through the roof into your base. So it can be, quite intense at times. We've been really fortunate so far. It looks like they want to besiege the colony and pound you with artillery from a distance. You can try to wait them out, or you can go get them. Jump to location. They always seem to drop down into this area. I wonder why that is. I wonder if that's pre-selected when you start the map, or if it just goes the opposite place of the map than where you are. In other words, it's programmed to never land right here, because that's not much of a long-distance siege, huh? Well, I don't see the sniper rifle, so I assume I did get it back onto Eric. I did. So, well, before they even land, who else do we want to make sure that we have survival rifles on? That's got their next longest distance or range. Rabbit is good. He's right now tending to Michael, and I'd like him to finish that, but he's already weaponed up. Okay. Dwayne, you were melee at one time, so you're not our best yet. You're still in the practice mode. Kathra is missing an eye. She's not there either. Who else is up that can shoot? Vapa, I believe, can. Charge rifle, but character 12 at shooting. Yeah. Vapa, you were relaxing socially. Joy, do you get excitement out of shooting? Oh, you do? Oh, the joy you're going to get when you equip the survival rifle. Let's run through real quick. Who else is really good at shooting but does not have a survival rifle? I like survival rifles. They shoot fast, and they repeat quickly, but they don't have much distance. And that's an issue with a siege. Manuel, an 8. Here we go. Rabbit's already on his way. Okay. Nettie? She can. She's the trigger-happy one, which means she shoots quickly, and her accuracy is increased, though. It just takes her much longer to shoot, but yeah, that's okay. She is definitely a candidate. Come over here and grab this survival rifle as well. We have any other choices? That's it on survival rifles. Okay. So, Nettie, Rabbit, Vapa, and there was one more. But continuing through the list, Brand is also good at it. He's still got a charge rifle. And that's all that we've got available, right? Everything else will have been shifted over to here after that last sale, and we cleared a lot of this out. Because this is critical and this is not. And even these two will be shifted over eventually. So, that's it. So, Brand, you are in charge of our backup. Our second wave. Okay, so Rabbit has got to finish this and then he's going to be on his way. Eric, you're first. Needs, you're good. They're landing here-ish. We're going where? How do we want to lead them? Can't get through there. Oops. Let's think about this for a while. Where do I want to send them down to? I mean, last time they were here too, and we parked ourselves right in here. Let's send them to here, and then we'll fine-tune. Okay, so we've got Eric, Draft, come on down into... Lost ya. Here. And let's go this way. Rabbit, Michael, Brand, Rokes, Klaus, Eric, Vapa. You've still got to get your rifle. Okay. Okay. And Vapa, Dwayne, Nettie is going to get her rifle. Who was the fourth? Was that it? Okay, Rabbit was the fourth. We're still waiting on him. Okay, Rabbit's done. And making kibble. Needs, he's in good shape. Rabbit, come on down. Draft, head to this area. Did they land yet? They did land. Okay. I heard a click-click, so who got in there first? Vapa is still on his way. Nettie is ready. Needs, she's in good shape. Draft, hop down here as well. And we will let Vapa grab... Oh, I didn't realize I hit the pause. Okay, Vapa is loaded. Okay. And in good shape. Draft, and head into here too. Alright, they're on their way. Let's see who we've got here. Bear, not hungry. That's not going to help. We've got a naked guy named Odie. Oh dear. Constraining clothes. He is a nudist. Well, that could be exciting to draft into our colony. Anyway, what do we have here? A triple rocket launcher. Oh, joy. Oh, dee, oh, dear. All right. He's our target. Wow. Farley with the devil ears here. Look at this hair. Social, what do I want here? Gear. Sniper rifle. Great. We've got a mace. We've got a pistol. Charge rifle. Just this one left? Frag grenades. Okay. So frag grenades, sniper rifle, and triple rocket launcher we've got to take down. Those are our first targets. Triple rocket launcher. That's most likely going to be ranged. And this one's decent. Odie's got some decent skill. Sniper, zero shooting skill. We've got a chance here now of not being hit by a sniper rifle. Frag grenades will also be, and that's a one. Okay, so that's a bonus toward us. That's where RimWorld is giving us a break. Who would equip a sniper rifle with no ability to shoot it? Otherwise, melee is this guy, and he doesn't have any skill either. Charge rifles. Those are actually quite lethal if you're within range. So there's a shotgun. 7. Charge rifle. 8. That one's a little bit dangerous. And 12. Pistol. If they get within range, they're going to hit us. That's the frag grenades. Okay. So that's who these guys are. Our people are coming down. Meanwhile, they're going to start setting up base. We're going to see the drop pods coming in with all their supplies. Zoom out a little. Eric should be on his way soon. Where are they going to set up? They're actually going to be a lot closer than I was expecting. So I'm going to change Eric to there for now. Yeah, they're coming up a lot higher than we're used to. Okay. While this is happening, batteries are a factor really good. Let's trigger this for a toggle and this for a toggle. And that's not it. This guy. And in fact, let's make sure this one gets done first. We're going to start running on this battery bank to recharge it. And that's our backup. So just happen to notice that. Klaus, you are resting. But before you do, go ahead and grab that one. Otherwise, we need to get turrets turned on here. How are we doing in here? These did not get built. We're still building the security wall out over here. Okay. Bran, that's right. Siege. I always forget this till it's almost too late. Man, this guy. Who else can aim that is still here? Dwayne did a really good job last time, though it is 11 o'clock and he's a night owl, of sending the mortars in. Speaking of night owls, that's something else that I did before the episode. Restrict. I went ahead. I've been getting requests, or actually suggestions, that both 10 to 6 p.m. and 11 to 6 p.m. are the time zones for night owls. Really, it depends on which alpha version. I think it was from 14 on and 15 on, so I'm still not sure what 13 required for night owls. But what I think I'm going to do is the 10 o'clock window is to give everybody social, everybody joy, with the idea that the night owls and the day timers will all be able to interact and get their social worked up, and then the night owls will head off and go to sleep. And remember, these are just trigger points. The game at each one of these looks at their schedule to see if they've got at least below a soft sleep trigger to designate sending them to bed. If they're fully rested, they're going to stay up the whole day. They're not, you know, if they went to bed right here and woke up here and they're fully rested, they're going to ignore all of these. It doesn't force them to go to bed. It just says, do you need to sleep? Nope. Do you need to sleep? Nope. You need to sleep? Oh, you do. Go to bed. So it's a trigger to go and look at their schedule. But that is done. But by, you know, it was at 7 a.m. that I had this purple bar for several days now. And as a result, if you remember the last time we looked at radar, he hadn't interacted with anybody. Now, he's got quite a few points toward conversations with folks. So the more points you've got, you know, more green up here, the better they are. Let's see, does that correlate to... really isn't a social aspect. They may be in newer versions. So maybe that works toward joy. We'll see. I'm not sure exactly how that interacts in Alpha 13. Oh, he's a night owl. That's right. I'm going to need radar. Well, there'll be plenty for them to do in 4 or 5 hours. We'll give them both, or all three of them, a little more rest. Michael's resting over in here. Is he actually sleeping? He is. Okay. So, what I was doing, though, before I got all distracted, is making sure that these guys are all triggered to turn on. We got both of those done. Otherwise, let's see who's left over here and make sure that they have all got some food in them so that they're not ready to break by the time I actually need them to do some good. Michael, you are sleeping. Who can tend to? Let's see, that would take someone like Natalia. Although, you're not hitting a bar, though, so I can't make Natalia feed Michael. That's prisoner. Prisoner's where she would come in. It'd be someone with medical skills. Manuel, where are you at? I feel like I just saw you. Okay, go this way. Manuel, you've got some doctoring triggered on your schedule. You cannot. Okay, so no one can feed Michael, and to send him out means that he won't go back to sleep because he's nowhere near his soft break point on rest to be a trigger to go back to bed. So I don't want to wake him up. But Cassie, you've got a pretty good shooting ability and you are in good shape. Manuel's in good shape. Let's go this way. A lot easier to find them. Nettie's on her way down there. Brand is going to man a turret. That's right. I need someone else to man a turret too, which might be Cassie. We'll see. Food, Eric, he's on his way down. Rokes is eating a fine meal, a lavish meal. Ooh. Klaus, flicking a switch, and then he's going to go to bed. And Vapa's heading down there. Dwayne is in bed. Cathra, cleaning dirt. What else more important is there for her to be doing? I need her as backup in the base for when they break the siege breaks and starts heading toward us. Natalia, same thing. Cassie, you're in good shape. I think you're going to man the next mortar. And we do have some rounds over here now. So she'll be able to load it. Okay. You know, the danger part is that we're going to shoot ourselves with those mortars. Next, we pretty much wipe this all out. Radar. He's going to need food once he's no longer under the problem of being a night owl. He needs to continue resting. Manuel, sewing. He's fine for now. Yeah. Rabbit, Michael. Okay, that's where we started. So everyone's pretty much assigned and tended to. These guys are heading to their final place. We're going to see the supplies head down. Eric, your range is getting there. You're already going to aim. All right. Then I want this triple rocket launcher taken out first, and we can't get him. So in that case, run speeds. That was something else I need to check. 4-5. 4-5. 4-5. I'm looking right here. 4-9. Why? Susie is a jogger. Okay, like Cassie is. So Susie's got to be taken out, or she's going to run us down trying to escape from here. Chef is 4-5. Kalisti, 4-5. Kimmy, 4-6. Probably has some kind of an enhancement. Character, fast walker. Okay. Lynn, 4-5. That must be the standard default speed. 4-2. Because you... health... have got stab scars on a left leg. Okay. So Kimmy, Susie, we need to take out for speed. And then Odie, we need to take out for the triple rocket launcher. So in that case, your first target, Eric, since he's only just beginning his spread here, is if she stays within range, can you fire at Susie? And the only one who can reach him, although I don't know what the range of a triple rocket launcher is, but the sniper on who? On right there on Farley is worrisome. All right, so zoom out a little more. Let's continue this. Waiting for the supply. There it is. They've staked their claim. The base is on its way. Rabbit, you are stopping there now, and we'll see what kind of range you've got. Vapa, you three will all have the same range, so you stick next to each other, which is dangerous. That triple rocket launcher could go up and take all three of them out at one time. That's worrisome. Nettie has a slow run speed. That's worrisome too. Let's think about that. I need Nettie to be able to escape the fastest. You're going in this area. Rabbit, you've got the 4-4. Okay. Same issue. Not a lot of cover out here. And I don't want to build cover out here because they'll be able to use that cover against us. So it's, you know, it works both ways. That distance is the sniper rifle, which means, really, that's our arc right there. Let's put Nettie down in this area. Vapa, you are a 4-4 also. Yeah, I kind of split you guys up. Vapa, you head to here. If you have to, you can go this way. These guys can go this way. We'll split these guys up while Eric is still taking them out. We'll find some way to make this work. All right, so you four are assigned. We're going to see the supplies come blasting in now. Eric has lost his shot. Okay. Eric, that's your range. And you need to take these guys out. Let's get you to here. See what happens. All right, you now can take out Odie. Fired Odie. Odie is wandering. Okay. Now, we have someone else to be watching out for. Brand is on his way. Cassie is still on her way. Let's remember to get back there. I want to choose the target. I don't want them just firing at who they think is the best one. Meanwhile, Eric is just about ready to shoot. Rabbit apparently doesn't have a range. Darn. Okay. They're dead if they go here. What do we do? Rabbit, take the cover of this tree. Right there. Vapa. I wish I knew what was better cover. The tree or the rock. Go to this tree over here. Nettie. There isn't good cover from this position. If they were further down, we'd have a little more of an arc right here. But we're out in here. There just isn't a good place for Nettie. Well, Go where you're going right now. Ooh, was that a hit? Watching for targets. You are aiming. And you are aiming all the way up here at Vapa. That, when that goes off... And I don't know how fast it goes off, too. Vapa, you gotta go. We gotta watch this guy. In fact, he can change his mind at any moment. Darn it, this right here is worrisome. That's gonna hurt us. Okay. It hits, and there's quite an explosion radius, too. So... stand your ground for a moment. Meanwhile, Eric, continue. Anybody else aiming? Nobody else is. Nobody's got the range. Which tells me Odie does have some significant range. Vapa, you keep going. Oh, okay, he's abandoned. And he started over again. He can reach Rabbit. Rabbit, head up. Let's keep distracting him while Eric gets another shot off. That's the goal. Okay, he changed. Now, Nettie's within range. You go over there, Nettie. Okay. He is now watching for targets. Eric just got off a shot. Missed again. Darn. Eric has got a good skill level. Rabbit is the best, though, isn't he? Rabbit is now the best. 15. Okay. Well, as soon as he's no longer watching... Susie, I wish we could take out. And who was the other one? Farley. Okay. Susie, we need to deal with too. But boy, Odie, we got to take down. How best? Let's circle Vapa. You're still in good shape. Around to here. Can we do that and stay out of his range? Oh, we've got incoming. Right there. Who's that from? That's from Cassie. Brand, 27 seconds. Let's set a target for him. I knew I was going to forget them, and I did. Your target's right there. All right. Cassie, your new target is there. Okay. Let's see what happens here. Coming in right there. Meanwhile, Eric is getting ready for another shot. Vapa's going around. Rabbit, you are going to try one more time to get into range. Nettie, you are as well. You guys will be a distraction, so Eric can keep shooting. Odie is wandering now. He's no longer aware that he's being shot at. Okay, these guys are building walls. Where's that round? Right there. Missed completely. It's incendiary, so it's going to light all this on fire. That is the downside. We're going to burn some of the stuff that we want to come back and get. But it also distracts them and makes them put out fires. It'd be nice to send just frag shots down here and just blow up things. But if we keep hitting around it and never hit them, it won't faze them at all. They'll completely ignore it. So, another shot went off. I don't think we have hit anybody yet. We haven't, and that is surprising. Eric's continuing. Nobody is aiming. All right. You guys getting in a view yet? Rabbit? Nettie? Nettie's got a... drawing a bead on someone. Chef. All right. You are beating out fire. Ooh, that's good. That means, Nettie, you can back up a little bit. Let's get you back to... what's your range look like? To there, yeah. Let's get you back to here. Rabbit, you stay where you are. Vapa? You're going around. Let's get them to get to the other side of them. I think you're safe to go to there. Let's do that. Eric, you're still drawing a bead on someone. I still need you to take out Odie. Is he still in your range? Ah, Odie is caught on. Okay. Nettie, range? You're out of range, but he could still fire at you. But I'm thinking that is... well, that line does... kind of looks like right here. I don't know which one he's got. Now, I just send you back, right? I did. Okay. All right, so... let's watch the circles. missed. You got it. You're going there now. There. And Nettie's moving. Rabbit, you got a shot. You are building sandbags. You are beating out fire. Beating out fire. Okay, let's watch this. Missed. Come on, Eric. Go. Go, 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 Eric. Go, go, go. Oh, that was bad. He's down. Okay. Nettie, you're over here. You're in rescue mode. Okay, and we are shooting up that way, aren't we? Let's see who's doing what now. Odie is wandering again. He's out of range. Nobody is... You are aiming? You're building sandbags. Okay. So nobody else is the target. Eric is down. How down is Eric? Health. Alright. Bleed rate is pretty high. Shredded. Torso. Jaw crack. Left arm. Shredded. Cracked. Shredded. Nothing is missing. He's repairable. We will rebuild him. Nettie. No one's noticing anymore, so let's just go directly to... Huh? Arrest? Oh, rescue. I saw arrest. So far, I want to make sure that no one... Farley is. He's got a sniper rifle. He's going after... Who? It's pretty likely going to be Rabbit. I don't think he can hit him. Not with a shooting skill of zero. I'm going to leave Rabbit there. That's iffy. But I'm going to do it. Odie. Rabbit. Odie's not in your range. He is not. I need Rabbit. How soon? How close are you to shooting? Doesn't really tell me. I'm guessing he just shot, right? Yeah, that's him. Rabbit, actually, go there. And you're going to pick up the sniper rifle. Okay. Farley's going to shoot. He gave up. Now he's going after Vapa, who didn't get a shot off. So he is still not in range. That's the tough part. Sniper rifles have got such a range. So Vapa, just head back over here for now. So far, we're not doing that great a job. Nettie, hope nobody notices yet. Farley did. Rescue and go. That's not a no. Okay, so they're building. We have a rescue mission going. Rabbit, sniper rifle's right there. Rabbit, you're going here. Vapa. Where's Odie? You can get in range with Odie out of the line of sight and Farley out of a line of sight. You might be able to take somebody else out. Boy, how do we do that? Again, there's no good cover other than trees. What do you need? Where do you need to be to hit anybody? You need to be right in here. And you'll never get out of there before the triple rocket launcher. Wait a minute. Gear. Triple rocket launcher is a one-time use. That's right. Odie is now weaponless. It's a one-time use and it's done. That's the disadvantage to a triple rocket launcher. Okay. So with that, I just noticed I can cancel these. With that, we only have two targets left. Susie, because of her run speed. Yes. And Farley, because of his sniper rifle. Okay, that changes things. Vapa, you're heading back. Hate to keep running you all around the map, but now you don't need to be down here. We're running Eric back to get treated. And Michael ought to be up in time to do that. Eric, a rabbit is running down to get the sniper rifle. You guys haven't noticed him yet. Farley has, but he's not much of a threat. Are you still in range? Let's break that. You are. Okay. Rabbit, I can just tell you to grab that, right? Equip. Ah, we have a round coming in. Right there. Is there another one? This ought to be Bran's round. He's got a pretty good shooting skill. Let's see where he lands this thing. Ah, good shot, Bran. Aha. Okay, Farley is most likely on fire. Burned. Heart, leg. Okay, he's got a slow run speed now. These shells are going to go off, though. Well, these guys will all try to put it out. So he's burning. Kimmy, were you part of... Or Susie, were you part of that? You're not. You're over here. Anybody aiming? Nope. Rabbit, you're aiming for Susie. Right there. Out of range. Darn. You're so close. No, you're... Let's get your shot off. All right. Now can you aim for Susie? Really? Now you can aim for Susie. All right. Vapa, where are you now? You're heading this way. You are still out of range. Let's send you, I think, safely to here now. Then we'll work you in a little closer. Rabbit's going to continue. Oh! Hit right there. That was closer than I thought he could pull off. Even though he's burning, huh? That must be done. Watch him for targets. That was his cooldown period. Now he's aiming again. So let's get Vapa's shot off, and then we'll pull him back. Anybody else figure it out yet? Nope, they're all beating out the fire. Okay, you're there. And you're shooting for Susie now. And took her down. Dang. Okay, you're out of line of sight. You should be giving up. Okay. Can you? You can. Then let's just take out Norman. No. What's his name? Fire at Farley. Wait, what? Okay, let's try that again. Rabbit. Fire at Farley. There you are. And you've got really good cover. The chances of him hitting you are so small. So, Vapa. You're heading for there. Which should put you in range of somebody soon. They build their sandbags first, I believe. Then they build their turrets. Their mortars. So we're still fine. He's the only danger right here. He changed targets. He's shooting, aiming for Vapa. Okay. Let's look at that. Rabbit range. Wish I had a way of measuring that. That to there. Let's think about this. All right. So that puts him to there. Draw an arc around. It's something like that. Vapa, you're heading to there. It's iffy. Go there. Really, Vapa has just been bait. That's about all he's been able to accomplish because of this darn sniper rifle. What I'm curious about is if Odie will ever pick up another weapon. Doesn't have him listed as one right now. He's a heavy mercenary from the Murderers of Hostility. So, fires are out. They're going to all go back to work now. What's happening over here? Eric? Nettie? Where are you guys? I need to know that Eric is in a hospital bed. Okay. Work, Nettie. There you are. We're still here. As far as we know, Eric is still alive. He doesn't have a lot of red bar left. So, Michael is not... Michael's over here. He's got medicine right there. He'll immediately go to treating him. Okay. Alright. Farley, you're aiming for Vapa. Meanwhile, Rabbit got off a shot at Farley. Missed him. Vapa is about to get shot at. Let's go this direction. Ah! He changed his mind at the last second. Boy, bugs me that they can do that. Missed. Rabbit keeps shooting at him. Vapa, drop into there. While Farley's busy trying to hit Rabbit, who's hidden pretty well by that wall. Vapa may actually get off a shot before I need to end this episode. Let me finish this one up next time. Ooh. Okay, well, that distracted them. Rabbit's got a shot off. Boom. Oh, bang. Okay, Vapa. I think you can safely move in to that tree. You're going... Okay, there. Well, I think I like it there a little better. Rabbit, any target you want, just go for it. These guys are all going to be putting out the fire now. Meanwhile... Countdowns? 23 seconds left, Cassie? 45 seconds left. Anybody doing something that I locked them into that desperately need food? No, I don't think so. Okay. Tell you what, I'm going to shut this down right here and immediately start recording the next one, which will be, I assume, finishing this battle and doing some cleanup. I'll try to release both of them the same day, so there's not a lot of waiting time. And I'll stick in the title, you know, whatever episode number this is, part two. So it won't be too much of a torture to wonder how the outcome came out. But I like to take my time with these, and I don't want this to go into an hour and 20-minute video. So I'll break this off here. So this has been Noble Rambler. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you soon. Bye.